I have been called a feminist, and I have no problem seeing myself as a feminist, and not one that actually like to be boxed into any ideology or into any category. I break out of categories and I like to be free.
When one talks about Singaporean trailblazers in the world of global leadership, Noeleen Heyzer tops the list. From 2007 to 2015, Dr. Heyzer was an Undersecretary General of the United Nations. Before that, she spent 13 years as head of the UN Development Fund for Women, or UNIFEM. She's now written a memoir titled Beyond Storms and Stars. In it, she talks about her childhood, her UN career, her marriage to the late Malaysian opposition politician Fang Yuting, and being a mother of twin daughters. We're meeting at Tung Lok Signatures at Orchard Rendezvous Hotel to talk about her book.
Congratulations on your book. Could you share with us, you know, how it came about?
Well, I was actually having a lunch with my daughters, and then I was telling them about a book project that I was going to do. And I said, oh, I was thinking of pulling together some of my speeches, reflecting on the pivotal moments in the UN. And then they actually said, Mom, our generation will not be so interested in that. Could you tell a different story, something that would uplift and that would inspire, but also make sense to some of the issues that we are struggling with? And do please do it in a way that we would be excited about. So that is how the book came into being.
What's the inspiration behind the title?
Well, Beyond Storms is easy to understand, right? All of us have got struggles. Stars are like your destiny. You're born with a certain set of stars, and that's it, right? So I question that. The other thing about stars is that they are the compass, stars that guide us. So in a sense, we have many moral compass, and we also have values that guide us. But values that are not lived will not actually bring about the type of transformation we all want. So in a sense, it's really going beyond storms and stars. If we have enough struggles, we have enough understanding of destinies, but at the end of the day, we have to take our destinies into our own hands. We have to make sure that our values live. It's also a celebration of the human spirit, individually and collectively, that have to find a way of thriving in an imperfect world and make the type of changes that we would like to see.
In your career, you've done a lot to help uplift women. How would you describe the state of women in Singapore?
What we need to look at in Singapore today, not so much the women who have succeeded, but the women who are still struggling. The issue of having women in the informal sector and why they need to work part-time or in low wages, and the undervaluation of what they have done. And it's only because of COVID-19 that we realize that the work they do are so essential to keep our societies going, the healthcare system, the community care services, you know, the food sector. Singapore is also undergoing an aging population. Many of the older old also happen to be women. They're not financially well off. There are many of the children, because of the mobility, they are elsewhere, the families are smaller. So the issues of care for the aging old, especially of older women, I think that's very, very critical. So we are in a small city state. How do we interact with our neighborhood and also globally? How do we not get caught up with many of the geopolitical rivalries and competition that is going on and can still thrive? So looking for new dynamism for Singapore, it has to be, of course, national based, but it also has got to be regionally engaged and globally engaged.
Thank you very much for having lunch.
No, thank you, Sumiko. It's been really lovely.